What's up, Simonics, and welcome back to a special video, because today we're finally talking about memory leaks and debugging the performance of your Ionic applications. So usually you come to this problem when your application reaches a certain size. At some point, you might get reviews from people using application that it becomes slow after a certain time, that it crashes in some cases when people use it, and usually you have no idea why this happens, because there are no real bugs inside the code, you can't replicate anything like this with easy tests, and then it is time to debug your performance. To understand why these things happen, we first of all have to understand the general of memory allocation. So, to put it quite easy for every programming language, you allocate memory, you use the memory, you free the memory. That's basically the idea of how it works. Now, the problem is when you allocate memory and use it, and in the end you don't free it. And sometimes this stacks up, so elements keep hanging around and just blow up your memory. And at some point your application will crash because there's no more memory left. Now, there are multiple ways to create memory leaks in your application, but usually within Ionic or Angular applications, there's one thing that we all have done, we all do in our application, and that's not managing observables correctly. That's really usually like 99% of the time, if I try to inspect a problem and figure out the memory leak, it is related to observables. Therefore, today I will show you, first of all, how we can find memory leaks in our application using the browser debugging tools. So we really want to quantify why there's a certain memory leak and really see it in numbers, because otherwise I just have this blurry feeling that something's not wrong or not right, and then I'm fixing something and maybe it's better or maybe not. Really, you need to quantify these things and you need to see the result of your changes. So we're going to see how memory allocation works and how we can really see the problems. Then we're gonna take a look at what is actually causing those problems, and of course also the solution, so how we can handle this better in the future to prevent memory leaks. If you enjoy videos like this, also make sure to check out the Ionic Academy, my place to help you with everything Ionic. Questions like these are answered in our community, so check it out if you wanna build epic Ionic apps. But now, let's dive into debugging memory leaks. Alright, I've prepared a super simple application with just two pages. You don't really need the code. We will take a look at this later on. For now, you just need to see that basically the two pages look mostly the same. They have a huge list of items, and we suspect that there might be a problem, because you usually start profiling, looking for memory leaks if there's already a problem with your application. Although I would recommend you do it a bit earlier during development, as then you can already see bad patterns that you're using in your application and you can fix this more easily. But usually it happens after apps hit a certain size, and then it becomes really painful. So if you're tasked with that, let's run your application. Let's go to the performance tools of the debugging tools right here and select memory, because we want to take a look at how much memory is actually used in our application. And you would usually walk through your application and then expect this graphs, but I'm going to just do it as a little comparison for you with two different examples right here. So let's start this, and I'm going to enter this page about 5 times so we can see the effect. There are 3, 4, and 5. Now at the end, now I'm gonna run manually the garbage collector or trigger it, just to make sure that the browser is really freeing up everything that should be freed normally. So that's just a little, please free it now. Okay, what we see right here is an interesting graph. I've already disabled a bit, so document just stays the same usually. It's not really interesting. GPU memory isn't even visible. We could add listeners if we want to. That's gonna make things a bit stranger. But what we see in here is that our JS heap, the blue line and the green line for the nodes, is constantly going up and then going a bit down. So that usually happens when we enter the page and then we leave the page again. The problem with this graph is that we could now draw a line from here upwards, and we see an increase of the JS heap size over time. That is the first indication. It doesn't necessarily already mean you have a memory leak, but it is the first indication that there could be potentially something wrong, because not all the nodes, not all the heap memory is released, even if we hit the garbage collector right here at the end. Otherwise we would even be a lot higher. Not everything is released, and we stay quite high related to how we were right here. Now let's take a look at this, or maybe take a screenshot, and then I'm gonna clear this, refresh, and I'm doing the same for the other page right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There we go. Let's manually trigger the garbage collection and stop it. And now we're gonna hopefully see a slightly different picture, although this page is usually doing the same. So in the beginning everything gets more and more, but once we hit the garbage collection, which seems to not have run before, because it's only it ran here. Is there actually a node? No, but this is at the end when we manually triggered the garbage collection. We see JS heap going down, nodes going completely down once again. So sometimes this is really strange that in the beginning you see a bit higher JS heap than you actually, your actual application actually has. That's kind of a mystery, but you don't have to worry about that. But what we see is a completely different picture compared to what we took just before. So before, let's say this started down here, we would have seen this chair, it's going upstairs, and we end up with a JS heap right here. Now we see it's going up, but once we trigger the garbage collection, it's going down again. So this is what you want to see in a healthy page. And this here, where it's constantly getting more, is what you see when you potentially have a memory leak. Now, as I said, this is the first indication. Now we're going to go to another tab to confirm this. So you would probably run this, you go through your application, with the profiling here enabled, and then you're gonna see something like this. Then it's time to go to memory. And within the memory, we're gonna do two things. So first, we're gonna refresh our application. I'm really always panicking that I get different results, so I refresh constantly all the time. First of all, select allocation on timeline, and then we start this, and we go to this page, we go back, we go to the page, we go back, we go to the page, we go back, and maybe that's enough for now. And what we see, first of all, from this graph right here, is that the blue line and the gray line, I hope you can see the gray lines, they should look different. So if you leave a page, everything from that page usually should be released. In that case, the lines would go back to completely gray, or at least just having a bit of blue. But in our case, it looks like really a lot of blue continues to be in there. So a lot of objects seem to stay there. And you can now select these little things here right there. You can look into a specific time frame, and then you can look at these items. So a lot of this is going to confuse you and make you think, what am I actually developing? What is all of this? But there's a few things that you should be able to see in here, and I'm going to describe it as easily as possible, because the whole topic is really complicated, but you can get, like, it's like the 80-20 rule, or was it 90-10? I don't know. But really, you can get most of the results with just a basic knowledge. So what we see in this little time frame is already that we have a lot of detached HTML elements. We have some objects right here. Okay, scroll. Detached shadow root looks interesting. Detached HTML div element. So we seem to have a problem with ion items and detached elements in this view. Or do we have? Let's take a look at the good page profile. So we're gonna do this, open the good page, we go back, we open the good page, we go back, we open the good page. It usually just stays in memory, as you can see, like it is cached. So it's just there one time, but otherwise everything from that page is freed up, so all the bars go back to gray. If we compare this once again to this, you see a lot of blue. In here, you see everything, just this tiny bit. You don't really have to worry about that. But this stuff like this is what you need to worry about. So we can see in here now that it looks like we have detached HTML elements, which are perhaps floating around in the application. They're not used, but they're also not yet freed. And what we can do now as well, next to this, is a nice comparison. Can we actually do this in here? No, we can't do this. So we go back to profiles and go to heap snapshot now. So I'm gonna refresh this because of my panic. And now we wanna do a heap snapshot right now, snapshot number one. And then we're gonna do some things. Like, let's say we wanna go to the API example page for 3 times. And then we're gonna take another snapshot. Now we can compare those 2 snapshots and check what happened in between. So remember, we entered the page, which looks like it has a potential memory leak for 3 times. We can now select here objects allocated between this snapshot and the previous snapshot. And then we could filter this. And once again, we see a lot of HTML elements. We see the objects up here. Nothing of this is really helpful, but what I usually find interesting is if you start to look for something. So if you start to search for HTML, you're gonna see that we have 1,500 HTML elements. Could this be a coincidence that our list is always 500 elements and we entered the page 3 times? Maybe. Maybe we also in that case have about 1,500 ion labels and images. Maybe. So this is the first hint, and you're gonna have to make a few connections in your brain to find this out. And what I also like to take a look at is if you are kind of certain about the page or child components on a page, you can look for something like this, and then we're gonna see a different picture. Details page, 3 times allocated between snapshot 3 and 4. And now we're onto something, because now we can also look for a comparison, which I find usually even more interesting. And this comparison between the 2 snapshots, snapshot 3 and 4, and looking for the delta of objects. So it's no problem if you have like 100k new objects and 100k deleted. That's not a problem, but the delta is the problem. And if we now look for the delta of our details page, we see that 3 were created, 0 were deleted, and we have a delta of +3. Now, let's take a look at how this would look for our potentially healthy page. We're gonna take a snapshot, snapshot 5 now, and then we're gonna go to the good page for 3 times, just as a comparison to the previous page. And then we're gonna take another snapshot, and with the next snapshot, we can once again do the comparison to snapshot 5, and we're gonna look for page, the good page. And what we see in here is, well, yeah, we have one new, but we entered that page 3 times, so it's just inside the cache. It's not stacking up like the one we've seen up here. So difference between snapshot 4 and snapshot, come on, snapshot 3, we had a delta of +3. So we could do this even more, and details page would come, we have a lot more instances of the details page. For the good page, we would just have this one instance, which would be reused. Okay, now we're onto something. On the details page, we seem to have a memory leak. So how could we fix that problem? Well, first we should take a look at the code. On the good page, there's actually nothing going on inside the JavaScript. And inside the HTML, we have a list. You might think this list is kind of bad, but if we leave that page, all of those nodes and elements will be released and everything is just fine. On the details page, we have that same list in here, but inside the details page, we have something going on, and that is a subscription. Now, this is something you have in all of your pages. You have an API where you constantly get some data. This would also count actually for the router. So if you had something like the Angular router injected in here, router, And then you had something like this dot router changes. What was it? Or events it's called today, right? And then a subscription. That would be the same. Any kind of these things would cause potentially a memory leak. And in our case, the memory leak is this. The problem is that we're using an API service, which is also connected to the root of our application, and we're using it to set some data in here. Actually, I think we wouldn't have the problem if we just set the data like this. But anyway, usually you're writing to your class variables here. So this is the problem. And to fix this, there are different ways. One of the easiest ways is to keep track of your subscriptions. So I'm gonna add a variable subscriptions and make this a new subscription. And whenever you do something like this, you would just add something like const sub to store a reference to the subscription. And then you use your subscription object. I think I have a typo, subscript. It doesn't look right to me anyway. This subscriptions add the subscription. And once you've done this, you also add the on destroy lifecycle event, lifecycle, whatever. What did I say? I don't know. And within that, you call your subscriptions.unsubscribe. This is like the easiest way to handle this. You could now simply, whenever you do something like this, an API call, anything like this, you simply add it to your subscriptions, and in the end, you unsubscribe. Now, can we confirm that this solved the problem? Let's take a look. We could take a look at the performance. We could take a look at the snapshot. Doesn't really matter too much. Let's do this one. We do snapshot now. And now we enter the page three times, just like we did before. Remember, previously we had a delta of three pages. And now hopefully that delta is gone. So comparison to snapshot one, we filter for details page. And as a result, we see the same picture like we had with a good page. Now I could open this like 10 more times. The only difference we would see is plus one. We could now compare even snapshot three, in which we opened it quite a few times, to snapshot one. Filter and the details page again has a delta of just plus one. So this is one way to fix your subscription memory leaks. Another way to handle this would be to use the Angular async pipe. So in that case, you wouldn't use the subscription and then write the data. In that case, you would set something like this, this.data equals our subscription right here. And then within the view, we would add data async. This would as well solve the problem for us, because now the view is subscribed and Angular is pretty good at handling these things and automatically unsubscribing. So we can once again confirm this. Snapshot 4 is now the clean snapshot, and I'm just gonna go to this 3, 4, 5 times, do another snapshot, and then we're gonna see the difference between snapshot 5 and snapshot 4 for our page is once again a delta of plus 1. So using async pipe would work to fix your memory leaks with subscriptions as well. Third solution to all of this would be something like take until. So in those cases, you could add a pipe block where you add take until, and then you would have something like, how do you use this? This.subscriptions, please do the import right for take until from RxJS operators. I think I have to pass in, what do I have to pass in to take until an observable? Yeah, I would now pass in an observable. New observable. Would this work actually? Yeah, I'm pretty bad. I think you need something like a subject or a behavior subject. What's your problem? I guess it's just ESLint. It's sometimes really confusing me, yeah, stuff like this. And then within our ng-destroy, we would call like next, and then this observable complete as well. And then we would have the same effect. So we could also do this pretty easily within the service. I usually like this pattern inside the service. So for example, your user needs to be authenticated, then you could easily have a behavior subject or subject that indicates the state of the authentication, and all the subscriptions, all the observables you create have this block take until unauthorized or something like that. And when the user logs out, you complete this and call it next, and everything that's open would be closed automatically. So once again, either use the subscription and just manually bundle them, use the async pipe in the view, or use a pattern like take until or just take one would also fix this. So if you want to, you could also just add take one to all of your HTTP calls. And then again, start with a performance. Take a look at if your performance is actually increasing over time. If your heap size and nodes and listeners are going up, that's usually a good indicator for a problem. And then head over to memory, do an allocation snapshot, check here what's going on when you navigate through the application, if your data is released or retained. And finally, once you've done all of this, you can also do the heap snapshot, which should finally reveal problems in your application. If you're confused by everything that you see in that heap snapshot, I really recommend that you look for specific either HTML or stuff that's like Ion. I think with Ion you should also be able, for example here, to find Ion label, Ion items. If you have a specific name for your child components or pages, I would try to look for that and see if there's a delta to different snapshots, and then you're usually onto something, and most likely you're gonna find some kind of pattern that makes your page or component unretainable for the JavaScript garbage collection, and then apply a pattern, and then memory leak fixed. Alright, and that's it for today. It was really a long process, but I wanted to show you all the different steps so you can really do this in your own applications. Now, what I wanted to add in the end as well is, we've now seen this for observables, so getting data from API, something like that. But really, it's also for everything that you subscribe to, router events. As well, memory leaks can be created if you're using WebSockets and you're not closing those WebSocket connections correctly, or if you manually add some kind of event listeners in your application and don't release them or remove them in the ng-on-destroy. So really, if you encounter memory leaks or suspect them, do the debugging in the browser tools and then try to fix them with something inside ng-on-destroy, which is usually to clean up after yourself. This becomes especially tricky if you have child components and then just a specific component is still in memory and you really don't know where to get started. But if you usually name your pages like the Ionic Angular standard page, you can really easily look for the page and filter for that, and you're gonna see the delta of pages, and that's usually a good indication to find the problem. On top of that, I really recommend that you check out this pretty long guide on debugging applications. It's about AngularJS and a bit older, but it covers a lot of details about the things that we've seen inside the allocation and the heap, answers many more questions. And if you really want to get deeper into this and understand everything that we did, you should certainly check it out. Link below the video. Otherwise, I just hope you enjoyed this video. If you got any other questions about performance debugging or memory leaks, please leave them in the comments, and we might have another episode on this in the future. And otherwise, make sure you're subscribed to this channel for videos like this in the future. I hope you will have a great week and remove some memory leaks in your application. Your customers and your boss will definitely be very happy about that. And I will catch you next week, like always. So, happy coding, Simon.